Praise the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters.
Praise the Lord.
A very, very good morning to you, my brothers and sisters. Today, we come to enlighten you with one thing. You know, Bishop Valerian D'Souza always said, the Holy Spirit is the most neglected person in the Catholic Church. I never knew what the Holy Spirit was till I came to the renewal, till I came to the charismatic movement. And then when I felt the power of the Holy Spirit, from that day, the Holy Spirit has been my partner all along. You know, it also says in the Bible, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Yeah, so that means we have to remain holy. Brother will tell us as to how we go on at our journey with the Holy Spirit. Yes, brother.
Jesus, before going to heaven,
yes,
he told Mother Mary, the apostles, and others, wait and pray and receive the Holy Spirit.
Correct.
And even Mother Mary wanted the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The apostles wanted the Holy Spirit.
Yes, correct.
Why the Holy Spirit is so important in our life?
Very right.
Because 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 44 says, there is a physical body and a spiritual body.
Body, correct.
This physical body always want to satisfy the body.
Right, right.
But the spiritual body want to satisfy God.
God, hallelujah.
But with this physical body, we cannot lead a
peaceful life,
happy life, or holy life.
Exactly.
So when the Holy Spirit comes into us, the Holy Spirit will control us.
Hallelujah.
Control our body, our mind, our eyes, all the five senses.
Senses, our emotions, our feelings.
Yes, emotions, everything.
Everything, correct.
Because any type of sins that I commit or you commit, it is only through five senses.
Amen.
When the Holy Spirit comes in us, and the Holy Spirit will control the five senses in such a way, you will do everything pleasing to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
And the second point.
Yes.
Many people are involved in lot of sinful things and bad things.
Correct.
And they do not know why. They say the world has become very bad.
Right.
But if you read Matthew chapter 12, verse 43, 44, 45.
Right.
Jesus said, the evil spirit or the devil needs a resting place.
Right.
That resting place is not a one bedroom, two bedroom, three bedroom apartment. The devil's resting place is your body and my body.
Hallelujah. Exactly.
Everyone's body.
Amen. Amen.
Now what happens? When the devil comes and lives in me or lives in you or lives anybody.
Yeah.
We will have the devilish nature.
Exactly. Exactly.
So whatever the devil has a nature, that nature will come to me or come to you.
Amen.
Imagine now the Holy Spirit comes into you.
Yes.
What happens? You will have the divine nature.
Amen.
The nature of God.
Yes.
Nature of Jesus.
Correct.
Adam and Eve was created in the image of God.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Genesis chapter 1:27.
Correct. Correct.
Now, when the Holy Spirit comes into us, we will be in the image of God.
God. Amen. Exactly.
In such a way that we will not commit sin.
Exactly.
We can never commit sin.
Right.
Because who is in you? Who
the
is
Holy
in
Spirit.
Us?
The Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Right, right.
And Joel chapter 2,
yeah,
verse 28 says, this Holy Spirit is not meant only for priests or preachers.
Correct.
This Holy Spirit will be given to all the people in this world.
Hallelujah.
Whichever
Hallelujah.
The religion you belong to.
Correct.
Whichever the language you speak. Whichever the faith you have, if you ask,
you shall receive.
You will receive.
Amen.
I tell you an example.
Yeah.
When I was preaching in Singapore,
okay,
I was talking about the Holy Spirit.
Right.
One lady was walking on the road, not a Christian, not a Catholic, doesn't know anything about Jesus.
Right.
She walked into the church. She heard the first day. She heard the second day.
Wow.
Third day when I was talking about the Holy Spirit, she said, Lord, if you don't fill me with the Holy Spirit, I will not go out of this church.
Wow. Praise God. Wonderful.
You believe it or not. Because of her faith, the Lord anointed her with the power of the Holy Spirit.
Wow.
She started speaking in tongues. She started the gift of prophecy, gift of vision.
Wow.
And she came and testified.
Praise God.
So, my dear brothers and sisters, keep it in mind, The Holy Spirit is not only for a priest or bishop or preachers.
Yes.
Holy Spirit is meant for everyone.
Everyone. Praise
Rich
God.
And the poor, educated and the uneducated.
Correct.
If you want to know more about the Holy Spirit,
yeah,
you read Gospel of John, chapter 14, chapter 15, and chapter 16.
16.
All these three chapters will help you to understand.
Correct.
Correct. How the Holy Spirit works in you.
Right.
And final point I want to tell you, why are you living in this world? For how many years are you going to live in this world?
Exactly.
One day or the other, I need to die, you need to die. After we die, where do we go?
No, that is important.
That's very important.
Yes.
You read Luke chapter 16, verse 19 onwards. There was one rich man and the poor man. They both died. Rich man went to hell.
Correct.
The poor man went to heaven.
Exactly.
So keep it in mind, when you have the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit will prepare you.
Praise God.
To go to heaven.
Heaven, heaven.
The Holy Spirit will prepare you to lead a good life in this world.
World. Amen.
The Holy Spirit will help you not to get involved in sinful activities.
Activity, yes.
So, the Holy Spirit is very, very important. If you read in Acts chapter 19, wherever apostles went and preached, the Holy Spirit was coming upon them.
Amen. Amen.
So finally, how do you know the Holy Spirit is in you?
You, yes.
Imagine, example I'm telling.
Yeah.
A person is, he smokes, he drinks, he watches all adult material, he doesn't like to pray, doesn't go to church. When the Holy Spirit comes, he will stop smoking, he will start drinking, he will stop watching bad things. Without his knowledge, he will start reading Bible.
Bible.
Without his knowledge, he will say his prayer, so your whole life will be changed.
Changed. Amen.
So, ask the Lord and he will fill you with the Holy Spirit.
Correct.
And one fine day,
yeah,
you will be with the Lord forever and ever.
Ever. Amen. 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 Beautiful. You see the power of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, both Brother Jayanand and myself, we don't leave the house without telling the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, go before us. Because Holy Spirit makes the way. You might be going to the worst situation in your life, but the Holy Spirit will go ahead and cool that place off. You'll walk. It'll be a cakewalk for each and every one of us. I do that practically every moment I'm stepping into my car, stepping into a meeting, stepping into some place where I have to go. Many a times for the ministry work, I'm going for a very difficult situation. And brother, I'm going to a man who might be very tough, and one of our persons has requested me, just go and request him. I send the Holy Spirit before him, before me. And when I go to meet him, whatever I heard, he's a cruel fellow, he's this, he's that. That man has become humble as a lamb.
Praise
the Holy Spirit has worked there, and I go and tell him, this man has a problem. This is, please let him go. Please let. He lets him go.
Praise the Lord.
And it's not my power, it's the power of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And I can see miracles and miracles work. That's why whenever I go to a place for a meeting, I walk like a king, because my Father, the Holy Spirit, is gone before me. Praise God. That is the beauty of it. So please invite the Holy Spirit every moment of your life and you'll see things change. Brother, thank you for this part about the Holy Spirit, which I always want to tell my Catholic friends especially, because Protestants seem to be only thriving on the Holy Spirit. We people have to come, hold on to the Holy Spirit. God bless you all. You have a wonderful day with the power of the Holy Spirit. Brother.
God bless you.
Hallelujah. Bye. Bye. Take care.
As we worship you, let all the nations hear our song. Song of Jesus and his blood that proved his love for all. As we worship.